last play was an awesome but maybe quite different love story. And now we will see another play by Shakespeare showing how confusing love can be. May I introduce you guys to Much Ado High School. Imagine we are at a high school dance. The different students are gathering around while being in different groups, as they always do. Here we have Claudio. He is the new guy. No, here we have Claudio. He is the new guy at Much Ado High School, and it's the first time at a school dance. There we have Benedict. He's just obsessively with avoiding girls, and he just hates them, and nobody knows why. Actually, himself doesn't even know why. You'll get to know later. And over here, we have Don Pedro.
You know, I am good. Not just good, but good.
He is the coolest guy in the high school. Everybody just loves him. Are Don John and Conrad. Don John is Don Pedro's evil stepsister, and her best friend are the ones who just want to make everybody so miserable. They just hate the school dances and everything. Everything about love is just sucks. There, we have a group of girls. Here we have Hero. She is just the typical stereotype of the young, blonde, kind of high school girl. She's all about boys, and you know, she just wants to have everybody. And next to her, we have Beatrice, and she's just like the opposite to Benedict. She just hates all the boys. She's like, you know, I'm never going to fall in love, and she just doesn't want to be with them. Over there, we have somebody who can't be missing when we're talking about a high school play. The nerds. They're just sitting there with their computers, not interested in dancing at all. And they kind of like overview the whole scene. They know what's going on in all the groups, and they will show you where we are in the play. Now the only one who's missing is Margaret.
And Mickey. Mickey, that's me.
We're her best friends and we're just following her everywhere. We don't have our own opinion, but it's all about Hero. Now that we're introduced to each other, I hope you're going to have fun in our play.
Come on! hear of?
They're just boys.
Just boys?
Just boys? Did you just say they were just boys? I can't believe you just said that. How can you say they were just boys?
If we weren't related, I would have drawn you. Oh dear, you're so funny. If I was in jail, then.
You know, I am a flexible guy. That's what's made me just a great student council president. Flexibility. Okay, I'm around flexibility.
You don't have to crusade anymore, you won.
No thanks, you don't, John.
DJ, it's DJ.
Not according to your mom.
Shut up.
Whatever you say, Don John.
I'm not listening.
Not so close, not so close. Thank you.
See, Claudio, my darling stepsister played a little smear campaign, jokey-joke, during the elections.
It wasn't really a smear campaign.
She told everyone I gave the large lady pink eye.
Wouldn't that make it a smudge campaign?
You better put those gloves on. Cooties are airborne, you know?
Thank you.
Please.
Yeah, I mean, I can talk to her. It's no big deal.
Okay, let's go then.
Yeah, well, I can do it on my own. I mean, I've talked to girls before.
Hang back, just walk. I'm going to talk to Hero, and that's fine. Any questions?
No, Lero. I mean, I've talked to her before, but you can go and get her.
I can't believe the paint scheme didn't work. It was foolproof. I even had the lunch lady convinced she had a pink eye. What do I have to do to totally be off his pedestal? I've tried everything, and every time he comes out looking like a sunny day. How can I disturb him? What about his dead motif? I'm exhausted. I've exhausted my evil resources. I'm tapped. Let's not have this. That just burns my butt. The new guy should be falling all over himself to ask me to dance. What's wrong with me? Am I pretty? There should be boys lined up around the corner waiting to dance with me. Conrad, why aren't there boys lined up around the corner waiting to dance with me?
The poisonous attitude might have something to do with it.
What do you know?
It's kind of a turn-off.
I should be walking on a beach all day like in the rain during a sunset.
Technically, there would be rain and the sunset at the same time.
I should act like Lerum is perfect over there. Lerum, oh stupid, stupid name is that. Her parents clearly are vicious. We have to come up with a plan to make the whole lot of them look like morons.
EJ. There are people listening.
Greetings and salutations.
Them? The nerds? The being a ship of fools would never listen to nerds.
Abominable accurate.
A comment on our time.
You're saying DP wouldn't listen to it. EJ copyright is not. That's now go on the brain now.
You perform a social experiment. Hey, Jan, what's your name?
John Barry.
For real? What's up with the parents in this town? You should change it immediately. Now listen. Are you listening?
As close as you can listen for Hardy's failure.
Alright. I'm going to make everyone miserable in the world's house. I'm going to destroy Hero's reputation so that Claudia won't ask her to dance. And DP will get mad at Claudia for wanting to dance with a girl who has a bad reputation.
Wow! Can you do that?
Haven't worked out the details yet, don't bother me.
Will you go and do me a friendly favor? Go to me and tell me my well, please.
Okay.
Tell you what,
something of that. Bert, do you look appropriate?
Tuck your shirt and say true to me, then.
Don't get hit by the apple.
Why did you take a crossroad? I shake an emotion, but always crossroad.
Would you go already?
He was spilling your plan all over the floor to make you look like the biggest fool on the ship of fools.
So, Hero, Clamu's going to take turn with you at the next little dance.
DP, DP, there's a hacker in the system!
That all right, you?
DP, I need to interact with you immediately. That's silly of me. A blue screen of death is recording me.
Now what about you, Claudio? Is that super fine too?
Oh, that's super duper fine with me.
I need to talk to you now!
Super duper duper duper.
Now, Hero, DP!
Hey there, hold it, watch the shirt there. What's up?
Well, DP's going to make everyone miserable in one fell swoop. She's going to ruin Hero's reputation, so that Claudio won't ask her to dance, and you will get mad at Claudio for wanting to dance with a girl who has bad reputation.
Oh, that's quite an issue, doggy. And I promise to bring it up with honor and flexibility at the next student council meeting. Who loves you, babe?
You see?
You are a genius.
I know.
Bert, we have an anti-Nazi chocolate. It's so romantic.
It's so touching.
It's so really lucky.
Be
Love, but humbug.
Exactly.
Shut up.
Yeah, they don't look like they're in love.
They used to go out.
Excuse me. That's not going out.
Benny and Phoebe sitting at the tree. K-I-S-S-I-N-G.
Throw us no with a stone in it. On purpose.
Oh. What? What is it? Oh.
It's just so sweet.
Come on, get away from me.
Come on, Mia. Be crazy because one of them are you. Who are we to stand in their way?
Well, nurse?
I think Didi has to say something than a different thing. Maybe he can give her a little pink and
forget. Okay. Please, every idiot who cares about laughing first will be should be boiled with his own pudding.
Exactly. Only not so much. I mean, what the f*** is your book?
It's indigestion, a bit of undigested beef, crumpies, a fragment of undeveloped.
These two crazy kids have fallen on the love wagon, and for me to stand in their way.
Great, thanks. They're moving too fast.
It isn't a true love wagon. Sure it is. True love always happens instantaneously, based purely on looks, without having a shred of information.
You two aren't in love.
Love and dances are completely disgusting.
Exactly.
I never go playing in love.
Oh, we're so happy no guy ever asked me to dance.
I never plan on asking a girl to dance.
Gee whiz, why not? I mean, girls are fun.
Girls have cooties.
That's so much more.
I am 100% cootie free.
How do you know? Have you ever seen a cootie?
And you?
I asked you first.
I ask you second.
This conversation is beneath me.
That's why I'm ready for you, Dar.
And why?
Ah, greet them girls.
You know, if those two kids stop fighting for just 1 second, I think they'd see the forest through the trees.
Sure, they would.
The sun through the storm.
Uh-huh.
The needle in the haystack.
Right.
You have no idea what I'm talking about, do you?
Not a clue.
They figure out that they love each other.
Oh. Well, are you sure that's what's going on?
He threw a snowball at her when they were 10.
Well, that's a different one.
If only there was a way to trick them into thinking that each was in love with the other. Then they figure out that they love each other and fall head over heels.
Oh, it's our specific two together.
Because a girl isn't happy until she has a guy to hang her hat on. That's right.
Well, gee whiz, I don't know, but isn't that sneaky?
Who are you, squeak tweet boy?
You see, Margaret is wearing an outfit pretty similar to Heroes. I will bet if they were in the dark corner, you couldn't tell them apart.
Go on, my dark-hearted, sandwich-hearted partner.
If someone saw someone they thought Hero was doing she shouldn't be doing, then that someone would be pretty upset, don't you think?
I think it's brilliant. I love the idea so much, I'm going to take all the credit. And as it doesn't look, then it's yours, of course.
That sounds like a pretty insidious plan, worse than the W32 blaster worm even. I postulate we should try and intervene. Let's calculate the statistical probability of DP listening to us if we set fire to this jacket.
Okay. My little chicken max, get around. I'm going to plan to get me and men together.
Well, Phoebe, actually, I think since it was my idea to get them together, I should come up with a plan.
course you do, but still, we are going to do it my way.
Statistically speaking, the probability of our
It's high. In town's altitude.
Wouldn't you two run a dance at a dance?
Who needs a dance when you have a laptop?
Well, you never have to worry about keeping the beat.
Our turn's your prank.
Are you crazy?
Do you know who would happen to me in jail?
I'm going to kill him.
Was he crippled, Claudio?
No.
Main Claudio?
No.
Is he on Claudio?
No.
Slap him?
No.
Kick him?
No.
Scare him?
No.
Tease his family?
No, I'm not going to do any of those things.
Then, would you maybe give him a wedgie?
That I can do.
Oh, my God. Oh, there he is. Don't let your body stick together to get better of you. I'm going to take a new one.
There's the man! There's the guy! There's the Baham man!
Did you just say anything about Europe?
Give us a little Dickens.
I don't feel like it.
I can really hear some Christmas carol right now.
She's not dead, right?
No. You, come here.
What? Me?
I have a little message for you.
Why?
We'll be right back.
What?
Oh, I just want to see a little Christmas in my life. Is that so much to ask for?
Words? What's the matter? My exasperation is that it's pink. My rose made with both hands and entangled into a Google plaque.
That's serious.
Stop, Barry. I have a confession to make. I am a romantic.
No, you're not.
I am. When I'm not calculating the statistical probabilities, I'm reading Harlequin novels. See, so I'm not going to let the two scientist lovebirds be ripped apart and create a black soul harpy who couldn't have the guy to dance with her if her life depended on it.
Hey, nerd, I heard that.
We have to find someone who will listen to us. We can't let this moment in time pass us by. If it's the last thing I do, that someone will listen.
Wow, words. That was very Bill Gates.
Gee, words, not the way.
Howard, you were splendid, various, and soon.
Margaret, how feelings?
No, don't touch me.
Do we want to dance?
No, don't.
But
no.
If please, would you like to dance with me?
What's the matter with you? Haven't you heard?